It works. Okay, the 10 minutes starts now again.
Okay guys, thank you for coming, thank you for watching me. Watching the presentator in the Tokyo Tech Science Slam. So let me introduce myself. My name is Muhammad Fajar, and I'm from the Nuclear Engineering Department, first master year student. And now I'm trying to present about my research. So okay. So, when you hear or saw the nuclear engineering words, what do you think? Anyone? You?
Uranium.
Uranium.
Yeah.
So, some friends of mine thought that nuclear engineering is like a bomb maker.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or even my mom thinks that in nuclear engineering, I can be like a successor of Einstein, finding a new formula. Or maybe my society thinks that in nuclear, I can make like a special formula to transform, become a book or maybe a mutant. Or even my sensei thinks that I can publish a journal as much as he wants. Or what thing I do in nuclear engineering, I hope someday I can get the Nobel Prize. And this is what I actually do. This case, don't tell my sensei, okay? Especially for my lab mate. Okay, but before I continue my presentation, let me introduce my mate. He's a seminar with me. So I introduce you. It's Jafar. Hello, Jafar. Yes, of course. Yeah, you already know. Come on. I only have time, 10 minutes. Come on. Yeah. So, last time I have a discussion with him, so we talk about the nuclear something and stuff. So, next. Sorry, Jafar. So, actually, Jafar want to know about the nuclear fission chain reaction. So this is the four introduction. Okay, so what is the nuclear fission chain reaction? So this is the fission chain reaction can be initiated mainly by two materials. The first one is uranium as a nuclear fuel cell, and the second one is the neutron. So when the neutron beam to the uranium, so the uranium become unstable. And this unstable can split into two new atoms, barium and kryptonium, and also produce the three more neutrons. So these three more neutrons will be captured by the other uranium, and then the reaction will be continued, keep continuing. So this is called the nuclear fission chain reaction. And the more reaction, the more heat generated. So in the case of nuclear power plant, we use the heat generation for making the steam, and then the steam will moving the turbine and then generate the electricity. That's a very simple explanation about the nuclear power plant. Okay, so Fajar, Jafar, sorry. So what is your question? Uh-huh. Yes. Okay. That's a good question, Jafar. Okay, I'll explain it to you. Okay, please stop. Okay. So this is the mechanism of control the nuclear. So as I said before, as long as we have the neutron inside the reaction, so it means the reaction will continue. And how to stop or how to control the reaction is by adding this controller. So for example, this is the controller. So when there is some neutron inside, and I want to control the neutron, and no, I want to control the reaction, so I just put inside the controller here, and then, okay, the controller will absorb the neutron. So after that, we can control the nuclear chain reaction. Okay, Jafar again. Hi, sorry, Jafar. Your song is so low. Okay, so you want to know about if I use the control, it means the nuclear reaction or nuclear reactor must be safe. Okay, so I will try to explain to you. Okay, so inside the control, I forgot to tell you, there are some boron carbide pellets. So this boron carbide pellets, the shape is like a marshmallow. Have you ever seen marshmallow before? But it's really, really harder than marshmallow because it's made by ceramic. So if you try to chew it, maybe your teeth. Okay. So the boron carbide, because it tried to absorb the neutron, it will produce the helium, the red highlight. Okay. So the mechanism is like this. The helium will accumulatively retain inside the boron carbide pellets. Then it tried to expand the boron carbide pellets. And what will happen? So maybe you can imagine that you try to eat a lot of food in your mouth. So maybe, sorry man, sorry. So it's like you try to eat as much as you can, and then your cheek become expanded, and then in the case of boron carbide,
okay,
your muscle become broken. So okay, I skip Java. Okay. I have no time. Okay, so the idea is, in my research, I want to use the carbon nanotube. So this is the carbon nanotube. The carbon nanotube, the size is very, very small, nanoscale. So if in the spoon, you can get a lot of, a spoon of carbon nanotube, you get a lot of carbon nanotube. And I try to combine the carbon nanotube and the boron carbide using the strong magnetic field. This is the mechanism. Okay. So this is the boron carbide, and we cannot see the carbon nanotube because it's very, very small. Like this. And then I'll try to give the strong magnetic field. The red arrow means the source of the strong magnetic field. So what will happen is, I can control and align the microstructure and structure also, as well as the CNT, carbon nanotube, and also the boron carbide. And the result is, I can improve the thermal and mechanical property. So I can make the long life of the boron carbide using in the control rod become higher than before. Okay, Jafar, sorry, I'm sorry again. Okay, so for the closing statement, I have a quote from the Spider-Man movie. So Uncle Ben said, with great powers comes great responsibility. So what I'm trying to say is, we are as an engineer or a researcher. So now we have a great power to create something new, something worthy for human life. And for that, we have a great responsibility to develop the human life, the quality of human life. So my name is Fajar. Thank you very much.